guys, it's Kelly and welcome back to our channel. For today's video, I'm going to be telling you the top 6 free apps on iPhones that you guys should definitely have if you are starting a YouTube channel. I really wanted to film this video because I know that a lot of people start their YouTube channels with their iPhones, and I feel like it's very helpful to have a ton of different apps that you can use to better your quality. These are also apps that I use on a regular basis for my YouTube channel, so this isn't just for people that only use iPhones. I use a camera and I use a computer, so you can use it either way. A lot of these apps are very beneficial for me, so I feel like by sharing them, it's very beneficial for you guys. I'm gonna get straight on into the 6 apps, and if you guys are not subscribed, please go down below and subscribe, and yeah. So the first app is Fonto. I love this app. This app is how I originally made all of my thumbnails and all of my banners and stuff. It's honestly so beneficial because it's completely free. I think that there's a couple things that you can buy. I never purchased anything off of Fonto, so I'm not too sure, but I'm 97% sure that it is completely free if you want to use it. I think that Fonto is perfect, especially when you're first starting out, because you don't really want to invest in anything until you know that you are going to stick with it. Now, I don't use Fonto anymore. I probably will in the future. I'm not too sure why, but it's such a beneficial app. I will never delete it from my iPhone because I love the app so much. So the second app I used to use for my thumbnails was PixArt. I'm definitely going to get back into doing that because my thumbnails always looked a lot nicer and more crisp whenever I put like different like outlines around me or anything around that. There's also a ton of different stickers that you can add on into your thumbnails or even just your photos if you're just looking into editing more photos. I think Fonto could be completely amazing just for editing photos and also using it for thumbnails. I feel like that's all I use it for, but all in all, it's a pretty great free app. I'm pretty positive you can use Fonto and PixArt for a lot more things than just YouTube videos. I feel like they're just very beneficial for me and what I used to do for YouTube. So the next app I'm sharing with you guys is something that I'm now using for my thumbnails and also my channel banners and even just like the text that I put up on the screen is Canva. I love Canva so much. Canva, I don't think is very beneficial or useful if you're not paying for it, because I think that they have a lot of things that are just more basic that you can create more skilled things off of Fonto and PixArt. I mean, it just takes more time. I love Canva so much. I pay the $9 a month, which I know can be very steep, but it's honestly such a great investment, not even just for YouTube, just for like life. I'm not saying that you guys have to pay for Canva. I'm sure that you guys can use it for free. There's just a ton more that you can do if you do pay for it. And also, you can always just stick with Fonto and PixArt. Honestly, they're just great. I really wanted something that I could do on my laptop, and I don't have a MacBook, so I can't get like all of those cool apps on Mac. The next app that I think every single YouTuber should have is YouTube Studios. It's one of the easiest ways to check your analytics, see all of your comments and everything while looking on your iPhone. I don't know about you guys, but my YouTube app on my phone sometimes doesn't send me notifications, but my YouTube Studio app always sends me the notifications that I need to reply to. It's also just a great way to check how your video is doing if you are running out to the grocery store or something. You're not doing that during this time, but maybe in the future or maybe in the past. Yeah, the YouTube Studio app is a lot better on iPhones than the YouTube app. I feel like the YouTube app really doesn't tell you much other than like I watch all of my YouTube videos on it and everything like that. But for me as a content creator, it doesn't really do much for me to look at that as a basis. So the next app I have for you guys, I don't really know exactly how beneficial it is to have on an iPhone, but it's TubeBuddy. I use TubeBuddy for every single one of my videos. That's how I figure out my titles and all of my tags. Honestly, without TubeBuddy, I feel like my videos would completely tank. I'm not saying that I have the biggest following right now, and I really do appreciate every single one of you that does watch me, but I think I wouldn't really get any views if I didn't use the right tags. TubeBuddy is essential if you are starting a YouTube channel in 2020, or even just if you're a smaller YouTuber and want to branch out and find new people that want to watch your videos. Again, I use TubeBuddy for all of my titles, all of my tags, and my description box. It is so important to focus on getting good tags because yes, you can upload a, let's say a grocery haul, but if you don't have like Trader Joe's grocery haul, 2020 gluten-free, like things like that, that people are specifically looking up, unless you have a huge following, your videos are never gonna pop up. And also TubeBuddy is insanely simple. I don't pay for it, but I do have a link down below for you guys to go sign up if you guys want to put it onto your computer, or even I guess download the app. But it's honestly amazing, even just the free version. Also, one thing I definitely want to add is that putting tags on videos is such a tedious thing, and I used to just overlook it so much, but since using TubeBuddy, it definitely helps because you definitely want to meet that 500 minimum or 500 maximum of tags, because if you have any less, then you're most likely not going to appear in search. So the last app I have for you guys is Voice Memo. I know that sounds so dumb because it's an actual iPhone app, but let me tell you this. It is the best for voiceovers. So let's be real. In a perfect world, all of us would have one of those snowball mics, but none of us really want to buy them, right? Or like most of us that don't really need them right now. So get your iPhone and get your headphones. I guess AirPods work for this. I haven't used my AirPods with it yet, but even just like the small ones with the microphone that Apple gives you, those are perfect. And voice record you watching your video and talking over it. Honestly, it makes it so much easier because it's so easy to talk into your iPhone instead of talking into your computer, which won't usually pick up your voice. And also, it's a completely free way to make a voiceover, and then all you do is save that and then email it to yourself onto your computer, or even just put it into your video that you are editing on your iPhone. I swear, all of these apps are essentials. They are great tools to have if you guys want to start a YouTube channel, and I would definitely recommend you guys go download them today. Yeah, that's all the apps that I have to share with you guys today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please go down below and hit that little subscribe button and hit the little bell so you get notifications anytime I post a video. But yeah, I will definitely see you guys here back on Wednesday, and also I will have all the links to the rest of the videos in this series if you guys want to go binge them. But yeah, I will see you guys Wednesday. Bye guys.